As I always say, the key to a healthy spine lies in a balance between strength and flexibility. For the flexibility side of the equation, please have a look at our video entitled Low Back Stretching. For this video, we're going to run through a beginner's program on how to strengthen the lower back. Now, if you feel any sharp pain while doing any of these exercises, please back off and do them at half or even a quarter strength. If even a minimal amount of effort causes sharp pain, please contact your physician or feel free to contact me directly through our website. Let's begin. We're going to start lying on our backs, facing the ceiling. And we're going to begin with what we call the pelvic tilt, which is really a pre-abdominal crunch. All we want to do is slide our hand under the curve of our back, either hand, it doesn't matter, and without moving the shoulders down or the hips up, we want to press our hand down against the table as much as we can, just by contracting the abdominal muscles. You should feel the pointy aspect of your hip bones moving slightly up towards your rib cage, and you should feel your sternum moving slightly down towards your navel. All the while, the curve in that lower back has gone away. And we can hold that for 10, 15, or 30 seconds, depending upon your ability. And for this demonstration, we're going to repeat it 3 times. But depending on your level of progress, it could be done up to 10 times. If you're doing this more than 10 times and you find it too easy, please have a look at our video on advanced lower back exercises. Now we're going to take that pelvic tilt posture and progress to our next exercise, which is the bridge. Hold the stomach nice and tight as you lift your body slightly off the table. Hold that for about 3 seconds. And come on down. And relax fully. Perform a little pelvic tilt. Maintain it while you bring your buttock up off the table. Bring it back down again and release. A nice pelvic tilt. Bring the stomach up, the buttock up off the bench. And come on back down again. Now we're going to take our legs. Start with left over right. Do a little pelvic tilt as usual. And we're going to rotate our spine to the right. What we do not want to do is come over so that we have to hold ourselves with the elbows or with the right leg. We want to actually use our stomach and back muscles to keep us from falling over. Do not push with your hands. If you find yourself tempted, simply put them on your chest. Bring yourself as far over as you can without feeling pain, without falling over, and without assisting yourself with other parts of your body. And remember, we maintain the pelvic tilt at all times through this exercise. And now we can switch legs. Again, pelvic tilt. Over to the other side. And back. Contract those abdominals, pelvic tilt, rotate to the left. And back. You'll find yourself only needing to rotate 45, maybe a maximum of 60 degrees. For our next exercise, we're going to turn over into semi-prone posture, which is face down onto your elbows. At which point we're going to arch our back and shift the pelvis to the right. And then relax, shift to the left. So I'm pushing my left hip bone directly to the left. To the right, and to the left. If you feel any spasm, any gripping down in the lower back, very simple. Stop what you're doing, get up on your hands and knees, and bring your buttock down to your heels as you reach out in front of you. And we'll finish up with a few more. And take a moment to relax and let everything return to normal. As usual, thank you for spending this time with me and for doing some of these exercises with me. If you have any questions, any concerns, anything that needs to be clarified, I can be reached through our website, www.chirotogo.org. There's a contact page where you can ask a question directly, send me an email, or there's information on how to reach me by phone. Until that time, stay well.